naton ako na despite of the challenge, no, kaning tawag na to health challenge, para di ka nako, bumbarog ako, mga tubang ako, gampo ako sa Ginoo, natagan ko niya kusog na mapadeliver na ako ni sa inyo, ha, ang iya mga pulong. Una sa tanan, magampo ta. May gugmao na mo na Diyos, nagaduol ako kanimo sa trono sa imong grasya. Nagahangyo ako na imo ka kong buligan o maayong panlawas na mahimo akong igmat kanunay o God sa pag-deliver sa imong mga pulong. Let it be, O God, your word will bring encouragement, guidance, and more understanding to my fellow Christians, Lord. Salamat, Ginoo, sa oportunidad karuntak na sa kabuntagon na imong mga pulong, O God, among paghahisgutan. Salamat po, Ginoo, na imong abrihan ang among alimpatakan, ang among kasing-kasing, and you will deliver, O God, deeper understanding on who you are and what can you do if we will entrust with you our life. Salamat, Ginoo, sa among mga viewers karon. Salamat, Lord, sa among mga kaubanan na they're hoping, Lord Jesus, that your word will enlighten them and will give them guidance, Lord Jesus, accordingly. Let it be, Lord Jesus, that this morning and your word will bring us, O God, together in understanding that you alone and alone with you are the ultimate things, Lord Jesus, that we need to do. Padikit kanimo, paduol kanimo, tungod kay ikaw lamang ang nagdala sa katibok ang sulbad sa kinabuhi, Lord Jesus. Kanya mga pag-ampo, pinahagi sa ngalan ni Kristo. Amen and amen. Men, sige, oh, padayon ta, igsuon. Karong buntaga, natay palagaisgutan na it's a life story ni David, no? Kailan man mong King David, no? Si King David, usa ka ni kahari, nagsugod ka ni siya bilang isa ka shepherd, tigbalantay ni siya o karnero igsuon, uban ang iyahang mga, no? Uban ang iyahang mga karnero dito sa kabukiran, oh. Na way nagdahom ani even ang iyang mga igsuon way nagdahom ani na mahimo ni siyang usa ka bantugan o inila na hari dili lang sa dapit kung asa siya kundili hantod sa katibok ang kalibutan. Even up to now we recognize David as the very admirable king. There are flaws niya na ay mga bangag sa iyang kinabuhi, pero igsuon, no, ingon brabe Dio diha sa mga pulong na David pattern within God's own heart kani si David, no. Karong buntag igsuon, atong hisgutan ang katong giagian ni David sa iyang kinabuhi na giunsa niya o kinsa ang iyahang tigbalantay o kinsa ang iyahang kanunayng duulan sa panahon sa difficulties ni David. Unsa ang determination ni David o nga nung gina-recognize niya na apart from that he can't do nothing, no? So karong buntaga igsuon, na ay titulo nato karong buntaga, nag-ingon, is there a refuge in time of hardship and difficulties? Mao ni ang atong hisgutan karon, na abay no, paglaom, naabay kapasilungan, mabanit, tama ba ni pagkabisayaan ni? Is there a refuge? Manong title na to, in times of hardship and difficulties. Abrihin yung mga Biblia, igsoon, very familiar chapter in the book of Psalms, chapter 91, verse 1 to 16. No, basahon nato na later on, but for a starter, mangutahan ako, can you honestly say, sa inyo ang kaugalingon that one way or the other, you lose your resolve and ability to recognize that there are solutions yet to be tapped but you already surrender in the process. Na may abot ba sa kinabuhi ninyo na sa inyong kaugalingon na imbis na mag-isip ka pa og solusyon, gikapoy naman yung ka. O ang imong unahuna, maragwa naman yung kuy kaya ani. Then you stop believing to yourself that there will be or there are solutions to be top yet sa itong kinabuhi. Or in the middle of an imaginable situation, you end up realizing that, mingon kasi mong kagalingon, oh no, how I forget that. Pwede man din ako ditong buhaton, pwede man dito na solusyon. Nga no man dayon dahil kung nag-conclude, no, pamaagi, no? Iksoon, karong buntaga, susama po ani ang kan David, pero lahi ang iyang approach, lahi ang iyang gihimo, lahi ang iyang pag-deliver, that even in the midst of the storm, even in the midst of the trials, even in the midst of imaginable situations of his life as a king, no, ang gihimo ni David na asigid ulan, which is money ang ato ang isgutan karon. By the way, for a historical background, how many times, no, how many battles did David did in his lifetime? Mutana ko sa inyo ha. Ingon mo, upat, lima, unom. Actually, it's 8 to 12 battles at is written in the Bible. No? Kani mga big time na gira kaning giagian ni David. Na ang iyahang gi partner sa iyahang pakigubat, no? Mauna kana ang Ginoong iyang ginaludhan. Say with us karon sa itong sitwasyon, pila na ba jud ka gubat ang atong giagian sa kinabuhi? Gubat sa panglawas, gubat sa atong relasyon, gubat sa pakigrelasyon sa uban, gubat sa pag-dependes kinabuhi, no? Daghang gubat na itong giagian igsoon. Dili siguro parehas ka David, pero susama po ang intensity na kailangan ni mo mag-desisyon sa imong kinabuhi kung kinsa imo ang kaubanon, no? Kaning Salmo 91 or Psalms 91, this chapter shows us the stark reality of two threats we face in life. Kanan kanaganing hagits kinabuhi, no? Threats from the enemy. Kung basahon na to later on ang katong katibukan na tong mga verses, and the terror of disease epidemic, meaning katong literal na sakit na gi explicar ni King David diha sa iyahang pakig-istorya sa Ginoo. Amen. Sige, ginota dito sa unahan. When you read also the whole chapter, you will realize that the shelter being referred to is actually a fortress or tower. Remember, kanitiman ininyo niya na mga word, fortress or tower, na tanaw na to ni unya, kinsa ni siya o unsa ni siya, nga nung kailangan magpasilong si David diha dapita. No? Na yung mga pangutana, Pastor, kanibang Psalms 91 is a prayer? Mga pag-ampo ba ni David? Actually, ningon diha, it's a faith, and Psalms 91, the prayer of protection. Mao ang meaning diha. No? Pag-ampo ka ni David, o pagpangayo o support o protection nga to sa Ginoo. As the times of troubles are upon us, the prayer of Psalms 91 is comforting and effective when prayed from the heart by those who love God and are in relationship with Him. Like David, sa panahon na kailangan din siya og salabutan, kailangan siyang support, understanding, kailangan siyang comfort, si David mismo, iyaha kaning ginahatag, iyaha kaning pronouncement. And let us read from verse 1 up to verse 16. Okay, abri inyo mga Biblia, igsoon. No? Psalms 91, verse 1. Whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge, my fortress, my God, and I will trust. Surely He will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shields and rampart. You will not fear the terror of night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in the darkness, nor the plague that destroys at midday. 1,000 may fail or fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. You will not observe with your eyes and see the punishment of the wicked. If you say, "The Lord is my refuge," and you make the Most High your dwelling, no harm will overtake you. No disaster will come near you or near your tent, for he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. They will lift you up in their hands so that you will not strike your foot against stone. You will tread on the lion and the cobra. You will trample the great lion and the serpent. Because he loves me, says the Lord, I will rescue him, I will protect him, for he acknowledged my name. He will call on me and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. Verse 16, with long life I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. Let God add blessing upon the reading of his word. What a wonderful prayer and a gesture of expectations of David to the Lord himself. Let us dissect and dig deeper with equivalent understanding through the passage on how King David comes out with a personalized prayer direct to God, and why this prayer is so intense and timely and securely. No? Ato aning hisgutan karon na nganong kanina mga pag-ampo, kanina mga pamaagi ni David tubangas Ginoo, pinakagwapo na iyang gihimo tubangan diha. But first, let me tap at least one or two historical background of King David life story which give us why this kind of prayer of being altered and delivered to God in heaven. Again, ningon ko sa inyo ha, it is because in his lifetime, David fought around 8 to 12 significantly blooded war on his lifetime, not to mention the childhood battle he experienced with being a shepherd, killing wild beasts like lions and others. No? Bata pa si David, daghan kasi experience. Then, hantus sa pagdako niya, so much yun ang experience. Lahit man battle ko sa una, ay sinundang ngay, manggod, sundang gamiton, uman, ispaa ka ng pana, no? Bangka o unsa. Not compare ka ron, isa kabungkagan lang ni mo, labayan ka granada, pero sa una, kailangan mo, dikit yun mo, magdikit yun mo para makaver ni mo ang imong kalaban. On this passage, we can identify actions or realizations or answers from God to the prayer of King David, whom I believe in our present situations can be achieved also or experienced by our own lifetime. No? Di kumutuo na dili ni ipahatag po si Ginoo nga to kanato. Actually, na-experience na po nato ni. Siguro, wala lang jud nato na po na. Pero si David, iyang giyatagag emphasis. Giyatagan dyan niya o daku kaayong kanang pagpasalamat ba sa iyang kinabuhi. Number one, no? We can identify through this passage, number one, a word of deliverance. No? Deliverance speaks about the actions of being rescued or set free. No? Kasabot ba tayong anak igsoon? Kanang ganyan nata sa sitwasyon na kailangan ka o kanang kaalalay, kaagapay, kung tawago nato. As we read verse 1 to 8, we can say that God answered King David's prayer and deliver him from the enemy. The stark reality of the threats we face in life, the threats from the enemies directly, itong ginatawag nato na mga katumang kalaban dyan niya, and the terror disease in the night or epidemic disease, no? Kay may experience po na ba dyan ang iyahang lugar ni ini o ang iyahang gisakupan, no? Ingon diha sa verse 1, whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of Almighty. I will say to the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. Actually, kung imo nin basahon manggod ang imo mong pag-deliver ko nani sa templo human, iyan yung gina-shout out, iyan ginamura, gina-kanta, gina-ana niya dito sa Ginoo tungod kay experience yun niya ba ang kaayos Ginoo, no? Ing ana ang kamaayos sa Ginoo sa kinabuhi ni David, na God delivers him in times of trouble, no? Psalms chapter 34 verse 4. Ingon diha, I sought the Lord and He answered me. He delivers me from all my fears. Glory to God. Si David, unsa day siya kaisog, tanaw nako sa iyaha, yet ang iyaha gyapong ginatawag, kanang word na sought, kanang ginatawag, kanang gina-locate o gina-pangita, ang iyaha ang ginadamgo perminti, gina-aspire, no? Ang Ginoo. Every time na mangita ko sa Ginoo, ingon si David, He answers me and He delivers me from my fears. Kinsa di mahadlok igsuon, karon lang gani sa COVID, tago man gani ang mga tao. Naapoy medyo musagubang, pero actually, why isog karong panahon na igsuon. Tanan, nagbaton og maayong pamaagi na dili matapdan sa sakit sa COVID. Same with David. Hari ko, maayo ko, tikas ko, daghang kay kong mga army, but yet I will sought the Lord. I will call upon the name of the Lord and surely He will answer me and He delivered me from fears. Another thing, same with Psalms 34, but in verse 17, ingon siya, the righteous cry out and the Lord hears them. He delivers them from troubles. Glory to God. Hallelujah, Lord. Deliver us, O God, from troubles, Lord Jesus. Sa sitwasyon na mo karong Ginoo na dili na mo ma-anticipate kung saan nasa mong unahan, Lord, tabangi kami as you portray and as you deliver David, as you give David, O God, the support. This is also our prayer, no? This is our cry out, O God. Tama ba ta, mga igsuon? Mao kani nga tuang pagsyagit karong takna sa kabuntagon. Lord, tabangi mi, O God, hear us. Hear us, O God, on our quest over our life. Medyo lain ang amo ang mga panglawas, lain ang amo ang sitwasyon sa kalibutan karon, dili lang among syudad. Kundi, Lord, makita nimo ang imong mga kaanakan. And according to His word, the righteous cry out. And if the righteous cry out to Him, the Lord hears them and He delivers them. What a delivery of assurance dito sa Ginoo para ka na ito igsoon. No? Lakta ka na ito igsoon. Nga ito ang number one na tawagon pa nato na pamaagis Ginoo. Nga ito sa kinabuhi ni David o nga ito parang mandulpadulong nga ito ka na ito. Another thing, assurance. We can identify through these 1 to 16 verses that God gave David an assurance. No? Assurance. What is assurance? No, a positive declarations intended to give confidence or promise. Wala lang makahatag ani igsuon. A positive declarations of intended to give confidence or promises. Only God, the Lord Jesus Christ, can only fulfill and declare positive what promises. Dili ang kalaban. Kanaiya ha, pangatik, pero ang Ginoo, si Kristo Jesus, na ito ang ginaludhan, siya ang makahatag niini. Basahon na ito, verse 10. No harm will overtake you, no disaster will come near your tent. What an assurance. Naka sa sitwasyon ka rin, Ixon, na natingala ka, naka pagkatingala, naka problema, na yung mga challenges, dili lang ikaw, kundili katibok ang kalibutan karon nasa challenge. But according to His word, ingon sa diadicho, no harm will overtake you, no disaster will come near your tent. What an assurance. Is that not an assurance coming from God, no? Is kana ba tawagon ba nato, di ba na, positive declaration gikan para kaniya, para ngadto kanato through David, to David up to now, para kanato niingon sa diretso that you will be have a confidence that I will assure you no harm will overtake you. Glory to God for that. Karon, I need that para sa akong kaugalingon. Salamat jud Lord that you will bless me according to your word. Tungod kay, no? Sa ipod natin mga giras kinabuhi na kailangan tayo i-assure that we will become victorious paggawas nato. What a wonderful commitment by God to King David and for us as well. Is it not satisfying and assuring if we have a kind of God who are willing and automatically always there for us? No, kalami bagud ana. Ingon lang ganit nato diretso na ang syudas Davao, pag na may problema, dial 911. Lipay dahin tarayon kay naamay mo dial, naaday mo rescue. Pero kaning siya ang assurance sa Ginoo. What a good and a very good assurance. Naa dinis Biblia igsuon. Gi-alter na ni, gihimo na dinis Ginoo. Kaya ayaw lang jud mo pagka problema. Tawag lang jud mo sa tubangan sa Ginoo. Like what Timothy expect to God, that despite of suffering, he knows disasters won't overtake him, for he truly believed on the ability of God and very much confidence he will be delivered. Kita ninyong kinabuhi ni Timothy also, no? Daghan naman tayo panaghisgutan, no? Pag panaghisgutan sa kinabuhi ni Timothy. But look at this verse in 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 12. For this reason I also suffer these things, but I am not ashamed, for I know whom I have believed, and I am convinced that he is able to guard what I have entrusted to him until that day. Wow! What a glorious commitment by God. Si David, si Timothy at that moment, di ba? Batanon pa ni. Si David, si Timothy, man ang nahitabo, daghan na kayo siyang struggles, kinabuhin giagian. Pero, iyang ingon diretso, but I am not ashamed. I am not afraid, for I know whom I have believed, and I am convinced that he is able to guard what I have entrusted to him until the day comes. Glory to God. Like David, like Timothy, like for us now, kailangan lang nato mga igsuon, we need to recognize what is God and what can God, our God, can do with us. Another thing, in verse 11 up to verse 13, no, we can identify of assistance, and we can identify that God is fighting for us and fighting for David. No, let us read verse 11 to verse 13. For he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. Verse 12, they will lift you up in their hands so that you will not strike your foot against a stone. The actions of helping someone will a job or task. You will tread on the lion and the cobra. You will trample the great lion and the serpent. So on, this assistance can make your life safe and secure. To David, why he asked for God's intervention, why he recognized only God alone can help him, because of the intensity of the enemies. This assistance can make your life safe and secured. And we all know that if God are going to assist us, or everything will be possible. Ang uban, moingon din siya, kaya na. Kaya kita depensa sa ginuan in sitwasyon na ni. I tell you, David does it. Experience it. Nakuha ni David o naka-experience si David sa pagkamaayos sa Ginoo, of being a great help para nga to kaniya. God will fight for us as He fight for David. God will assist us as He assists David along with this passage. Psalms chapter 54, verse 4. Behold, God is my helper. The Lord is the upholder of my life. What a great declaration, Iksuon. Same with David. Dapat kita po mga Iksuon, karong taknas kabuntagon sa atong atubangan, sa atong mga atuang mga pamilya. Ato silang i-encourage. Ingon nato sila diretso, walay laing magbalantay, magtabang ka nato. Pinaagi sa pagproteksyon ka nato, kundi li ang Ginoo. Can you say amen to that, mga Iksuon? Can you clap to that sa abilities Ginoo para sa iyahang kaayuhan ngadto sa iyang mga anak o sa iyang suportang iyang ihatag? The Lord will fight for you. Listen to this. The Lord will fight for you. You need only to be still. Being still means that you know and your act and deed that God is with you, leading you and surrendering to Him for His guidance. So on, being still says, I am faithful and that I need and love and trust God. One simple action that holds so much silent, no, para sa atong kinabuhi is when we are faithful at atubangan sa Ginoo. And that the need of support and help maabot din ang Igsoon. Nga no, tungod kay naa ang Ginoo kanunay na magbalantay kanatong tanan. Hallelujah. When God tell us to be still, natanaw ko sa inyo. When God tell us to be still, what does it mean? Unsay pasabot ana para kanato? Kanong ingon niya Badritso, be still. Unsay pasabot ana? There is no meaning. There is a deeper meaning to be still. No? According to Psalms chapter 46 verse 10, be still, know that I am God. Dili lang unta ta, murag ani da pagka istorya ba. Kumpiyansa lang gud kas kinabuhi gud, salig jug maayo tungod kay ang ato ang Ginoo, Ginoo na nadi matandog. Amen, Igsoon. Ang Ginoo natong ginaludan, ginampuan like David. Ang Ginoo na walay pagkausab, na kaya kay niya ihatag para kanato. At the same time, He is our rescuer. Another thing, as we read the whole passage, we can identify that God is David's rescuer. But what does it mean? No? Rescuer saves someone or from a dangerous or distressing situation to rescue. Si David, di ba, kana man lang gani kang mutabok ka sa pedestrian lane, you are in a very peculiar and dangerous side of the road. Then mutanaw ka sa left and right, dangerous kay na, kay nga naman, ang imong mata ra ba, kay di ra ba pwede magtanaw sa left and right, bulago ni mo. Kung right ka, right, radyo ka mutanaw na po ka sa left. Then, you are in a very distressing or dangerous situation. Sa dalan pa lang na, pero kang David, a very literal dangerous life story niya. Pila ka gira ang giagian. Pila ka attempt sa iyang kinabuhi. Pwede na dyan mamatay ni si David. But yet, ingon diha, sa verse 14, because He loves me, says David, because He loves me, says the Lord, I will rescue him, I will protect him, for he acknowledged my name. Wow! As he is poised to do his plan, I'm referring to God. As he is poised to do his plan in our life and rescue us from anything which can ruin and destroy our life in the process, like David, what he need to do is acknowledge him first that he can really do it. Iksuon. tanaw nimo, di nimo kaya ang sitwasyon. Dili nimo kaya spilingon ang imong kinabuhi karon. Naka sa taliwala sa kagulanan, sa problema, or sa challenges, sa decision making, then, let us go to the rescuer. Let us rely to the rescuer, the Lord Jesus Christ. And like David, when he shout out to God, rescue me, Lord Jesus, tabangi ko, tuna ako sa taliwala. And he acknowledged him first. Let us acknowledge first the Lord Jesus Christ. If we wanted to be rescued, acknowledge him as your personal rescuer. Psalms chapter 71 verse 2 says, in your righteousness, deliver me and rescue me. Incline your ear to me and save me. What a wonderful prayer. What a wonderful utterance of confidence. No, lami ka igsoon ba, no? Mahingon ta sa tubangan sa Ginoo. Lord, sa imong pagkamaayo, sa imong pagkaginoo, Lord, deliver ko Ginoo, tabangi ko, i-rescue ko Ginoo. Paminawang ako mga pag-ampo Ginoo, o Ginoo, luwasa ako sa akong sitwasyon. Karong buntaga igsoon, sa atong pagkigatubang, sa pulong sa Ginoo, siya mismo nakigistorya ka nato. Na ako sa iyong atubangan, mga anak, na ako diri, anda maminaw ka ninyo. Ang inyong Ginoo, na kanunay, nagpaminaw ka ninyo. What you need to do is acknowledge me first. Acknowledge Him. Recognize God alone sa imong kinabuhi. Karon, ang mga tao karon, nag-face up na. Imbis pasalamatan nila ang Ginoo tungod sa iyang kaayo, to na noon, ang lalaki na himo ng babae, na cute daw ilang pananaw anak dito. What testimony you bring? I tell you, let me rebuke you. Let me rebuke you all for those people na ang inyong ginasulti lang sa inyong kinabuhi tungod kay. It's just for fun. Do you think you can mock God? Do you think that you can excuse it in front of God na Lord, kung alam man eh, Ginoo, dula-dula rin eh. Para lang ni sa dula sa mata, Ginoo. I tell you, God is not pleased to that. What is pleasing in the sight of God is righteousness. So on. Righteousness. So on. Hallelujah. And for our second to the last, as we read the passage in verse 15, we can identify comfort and shelter. Grabe, no? Pagkagwapo jud sa kahimtang ni David. Ingon diha, comfort and shelter, a state of physical ease and freedom from pain or constraint. Kulami bagod ani gud na pamalandungon na anakay masaligan na mo comfort kanimo, makatago pa jud ka na in behalf niya siya'y bahala nimo. No? Verse 15. He will call on me and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble and I will deliver him and honor. It's a commitment from God to David and to his people. Salamat Ginoo. Salamat Diyos sa iyahang kaayo. Dili bata moingon ta dito nang gabi, no? Sa panahon sa COVID, sa panahon sa pandemic, sa panahon sa sitwasyon sa kinabuhi, sa tanang panahon na akong giagian, nakalisdanan, hingon day ko, God is my comfort and my shelter. In your behalf and situation, remember that our God can embrace us and His mighty shadow of His wings brings comfort to us. Ang uban siguro, kung naman ang nalakay mamatyan, mag-adto ka dito, then mag-shelter, mag-comfort ka, maghatag ka, o ka ng kanang assurance at tagkakuan na sige lang you can hold on sa sitwasyon ug kinabuhi, pero dire igsuon sa sitwasyon ni David. No? What a comforting assurance sa panahon ni David. Isaiah chapter 4 verse 6. There will be a shelter to give shade from the heat by day and refuge and protection from the storm and the rain. It refers about challenges. Kinsan eh, the fortress, the tower na akong ginaingon ka ganina. It is God, the Lord Jesus Christ Himself. He is the shelter who can shade us from the heat by the day. The heat itself represents challenges, problems, tribulations, afflictions, disease, so on. Saligi. Saligi ang Ginoo tungod kay siya ang Ginoo na naghimo sa tanan. So on, sa panahon karon, dili lalim ang ato ang kahintang, atong negosyo, atong panrabaho, ang uban gani, wala pa sila kabalik sa ilahang panrabaho karon. Naa pa sila karon igsuon sa taliwala sa pagkamas-kamas kung unsa ang ilahang maaginod sa kinabuhi. Even ang pag-eskwela sa mga bata karon. No? Lisod na kayo. Tama tong gisulti sa usa ka senator na sao na to na itong mga pobreng mga estudyante sa far-flung area. Di maka-afford og cellphone, di ka-afford og gadget, di ka-afford og kwan. How can they go to, how can they continue their studies? No? Kanina sitwasyon na, grabe, overhaul yun. It's a 360 overhaul of the system. Kaya gani na, daghan kayong init og ulo. Daghan kayo og panahon na makaingon ta sa atong kaugalingon ba na Lord, ang sitwasyon dili inje mga katiyaw-tiyawan. Even ako personally makasulti jud ko na no, nanako sa tubangas Ginoo, lumingon jud ko Lord, nakita na ko mga tao nagsuffer jud. Unsa nang Ginoo ang sitwasyon? And God reminds me with this no prayer in Psalms 91. Tagan ko encouragement sa Ginoo, tagan ko og enlightenment, tagan ko o kanang encourage, kanang tawag pa nato na boldness, na courage, na kanagani ipasaka pa nako og maayo ang akong pagtuo sa akong kinabuhi. Tubangan sa Ginoo. So on, kung ang ato mga estudyante karon, tawagon pa nato. Dili makatungha no, kay tungod kay kulang jud ang pamaagi. Ato iduol sa Ginoo, so on. Ang ato ang mga kinabuhi, itong problema, ang ato ang mga challenges, no? Ang atong komunidad kami para sa mo akaron. Na ako diya sa pagpanerbisyo sulod sa pamarangay. Sahay, ingon ta sa atong kagalingon na kapo na siguro jud na mo exit na, gusto na ta mag mo muundang na lang ta, mangingani na lang ta. Pero bihay pod ala pod, ingon po ko sa akong kagalingon na ikaw may nagtisok diri Ginoo. Same with din yun. Kung asa mo gibutang sa Ginoo, karon paningkamuti ninyo na ma-please ninyo ang Ginoo sa inyong kinabuhi. And be reminded with this Psalm 91, a prayer of protections, a prayer of victory in the sight of God. Na makaingon ta diritso, Lord, what a wonderful gesture of support na imo ang gihatag. And lastly, on top of those, no, tawagon mo ito, support, assistance, protection, comfort, and shelter, or God being our rescuer, He coupled it. Iya pa dito ang gipadalaan. Unsa daw yung gipadala ka na ito? He coupled it with reward. Dili lang assistance ang gihatag, dili lang support ang gihatag, dili lang protection ang gihatag, dili lang being as rescuer, dili lang i-comforter, dili lang makashelter ta sa iyang gugma, sa iyang love, sa iyang favor, kundi ligyatagan pa dito niya o reward. By the way, what is a reward? Ngayon diha, a thing given and recognitions of one service or effort or achievement. As we achieve, as we effort, as we serve, no? Ngayon diha sa verse 16, and sa daw ang reward na yang ihatag, with long life I will satisfy him and show him salvation. Hallelujah, and so on. with not only those, no? Mahingon ta dito, mga butang na makuha nato sa Ginoo na karon dayon. Mahingon ta, Lord, wala ko'y pagkaon and food will be extended. Lord, wala ko'y panggasto and finances will be extended. Pero at the end of your lifetime, ingon pa dyan ang Ginoo, I will give you reward. David, I will give you reward. And that this reward is, I will satisfy you with long life and show you your salvation. Dili ba na maayog soon karong takna sa kabuntagon? That on top of being God as an our assistance, our support, our protections, our rescuer, our comforter, yet, the ultimate thing is He will reward us with salvation. But, before I end, here's the take. But with all of these positive responses from God, there is one qualifying thing to be done. And try to read in verse 9. If you say, the Lord is my refuge, and you make the Most High your dwelling place. Kung ato kaning, meaning, we need, or you need to alter it and pronounce it and speak it in front of God. That we need Him. That we need His interventions. That we recognize Him as our loving Savior and as our protector. Kailangan nato. Like David, in the temple, shouting, crying to God, and singing hymns to Him, no, satisfying the heart of God. Ingon diha, katong tanan, igsoon, na ay qualifying verse ato, which is, when you say, kung imong iistorya, the Lord is my refuge. Meaning, you recognize that God alone is our defender. Hallelujah. No? Glory to God. Igsoon, salamat sa iyong pagpaminaw. Karuntag na sa kabuntagon. I am praying that the Word of God will give enlightenment and guidance and encouragement to us. Unsa man ang kinabuhi nato karon na sa itong atubangan, unsa man ang sitwasyon nato karon, igsoon ang pulong sa Ginoo karong buntaga. Ingon diha sa titulo kaganina. No? Is there a refuge in time of hardship and difficulties? The answer is yes. In the presence of the Almighty. Diha sa taliwala sa ato ang amahan. O sa ato ang ginaludhan na si Kristo Jesus. Is there a refuge in times of hardship and difficulties? Yes, naa igsoon. Tungod kay naipaglaom sa ngalan ni Kristo. Mag-ampot na. Masaligan namo na Diyos, mapasalamaton kami kanunay kanimo na ang imo mga pulong Ginoo maoy mugiya ka namo. Sa panahon Ginoo na nami pagkatingala sa direksyon na among ginatahak ani nakalibutan, kaning mga pulong nimo karon o God, dili kanimo labay ang kawang, kundi dili amo kaning gunitan, na makahatag kani Ginoo kahapsay sa among pangunahuna, o mupadayon kami Ginoo sa pagkigbisog sa kinabuhi tungod kay ikaw, o ikaw lamang ang naasa among taliwala. Lord, I speak protections to those people o God, na among mga kaigsuunan karon. Naa sila sa bingit Ginoo sa ilang decision making, ang uban na bugnaw, ang uban o God wa nakasabot sa ilang kinabuhi. Lord, in the name of Jesus, I pray that this chapter of the book of Psalms, Lord 91, will give them so much encouragement, light o God at the end of the tunnel, that they will embrace Lord Jesus, that you are our comforter, our refuge, our towers, our fortress, Lord Jesus, that can defend us from any eventualities in life. Salamat, Ginoo, karong kabuntagon, Ginoo, that you allow us, O God, to dissect your word and give us the freedom, O God, to understand what you want us to be understood, Lord Jesus. Salamat, Ginoo, sa mga kaigsuunan namo. Even for those people, O God, dili na mo ginoosakop. But being covered with this live streaming, Lord, I pray, O God, that you will send forth your favor to them, Lord. Lord, continue to protect our city. Continue to protect our nation. Much more, continue to protect our family that we represent, Lord. We give you all the praises, the glory, and adoration. In Jesus' name.